All right, that was Rockets GM Daryl Morey repping James Harden. It's T-shirt there you saw him wearing with his film student daughter as his date. Very cute. Max,
yeah.
Does Morey have a point about the Rockets being the favorites next season?
He has a point. I don't think they should be the favorites, but he has a point. They know how to do this as a unit. They never win less than 50-something games. They won 65 games 2 years ago. The real issue is Chris Paul's been in decline. They lost a 3-and-D guy in Trevor Ariza, who they didn't replace, and their second-best player is in decline. Their second-best player is still good, and their best player, Ryan Hollins, is on here arguing should have been the MVP of the league, and at any rate is one of the two finalists for MVP every single year. So given that they have a cohesive system, they have Bizdelic as the D coordinator, which works. You saw they got much better as soon as he came back. And Ryan, you said, oh, how'd they do without James Harden, also without Bizdelic? As soon as they have the D coordinator with D'Antoni's offense, they've been among the powerhouses in the league, and you can expect them to be that again. And one of the reasons, Ryan, is because Daryl Morey with Mike D'Antoni realize keep placing those high-yield bets. All they do, as much as they're criticized by dinosaurs like you who bemoan the fact that they don't shoot enough mid-range or get down on the blocks enough, in fact, those yield the lowest returns. They only place high-yield bets. They take threes, they shoot in the paint, and they shoot free throws. That's it.
What?
Because of
this?
That, they're able to compete over their heads, and their heads, given James Harden, Chris Paul, and Clint Capella, are pretty high.
Why do you always do this? Why do you always hedge your bet? Why do you always hedge your bets? Why can't you pick a stance, pick a side, and stay on it? Why can't you pick a side and stay on
how
it, Max?
How am I not staying on a side?
You, the first off, you talk about how they're in shambles. Chris Paul's not the same. And then you try to pick both sides. What side are you on, Max?
Well, what side should I be on? KD and Clay
are they contenders or not? Are they contenders or not?
They're absolutely contenders.
They don't have a chance. The door is slammed shut. Here's the reality. James Harden's nothing short of amazing. We cannot question that. But he doesn't have the help around him. Their biggest window, their biggest shot, brother, as you know, was that Game 7 against Golden State. It wasn't last year. Why? Chris Paul wasn't the same. 2 years ago, Chris Paul was excellent, shooting the three ball off the bounce, creating his own offense, getting the spots. Your turn, my turn. They had a great energy. Heck, they had Trevor Ariza, probably the best, second best, third best 3-and-D guy in the league, however you want to call it. Trevor Ariza is arguably one of the best, if not the best, 3-and-D guy in the league. I'll give Klay Thompson the best, Klay playing, best 3-and-D guy, Trevor Ariza. Nonetheless, he's not there. Nonetheless, he's not there. Lakers just got better. Heck, Klay Thompson come back, I might still take the Warriors over him. Come on, man. And here's the reality. At the end of the season, what happened? This team absolutely fractured. Their owner, Fertitta, comes into the locker room, comes in before the exit meetings. Chris Paul's arguing with Harden. He's ready to get rid of the coach. Coach is D'Antoni's ready to go. Then D'Antoni's staying. This team, they absolutely fell apart. Then guess what? The season ends. You look up. Next thing we know, the Golden State Warriors are injured. The door is open. You know who jumped through that door? The Los Angeles Lakers. You know who's second up, third up, and maybe first up? The Los Angeles Clippers.
Actually, the Toronto Raptors jumped through the door because they were led by a championship player. Now, let's review. 2 years ago,
let's say Kawhi Leonard, wherever Kawhi chooses. If it's right. L.A., if it's Toronto, we'll say Kawhi Leonard, okay?
Sure.
Houston ain't in that talk, bro.
Now, here's the issue. Why aren't I saying James Harden? Because that's the real issue. Let's strip away everything here. You're right. Their best shot was 2 years ago or two seasons ago. Game 7 at home, conference finals. Mm-hmm. Chris Paul didn't play. I say if Chris Paul plays, they win that game, even without Chris Paul. And they're missed like every shot. They were 0 for 27 at one point from three. And that's not all the Warriors' defense. That's guys missing open shots. 3-and-D guys like Trevor Ariza, guys capable of hitting that shot like PJ Tucker. Naturally, James Harden himself. But last year, this last postseason, in the semifinals in the conference, second round, actually, James Harden had a chance to win game one on the road. Let's be honest. He had a look. Not only did he dribble out of bounds the previous possession, but then he had a look on the road to tie the game with a three Instead, he was so concerned with jumping under Draymond Green's legs and begging the refs for a call that they lost that winnable game on the road.
Was he getting fouled?
Then,
had he been fouled the whole series?
We're talking about that
play, brother.
There are
at least four or five instances where he should have got the calls.
Ryan Collins, shame on you. You just posted some MJ clip that I retweeted a couple days ago. You saw what the Pistons did to him. Did he beg and cry for calls? No, he just hit shots. James Harden blew that game. At the end, let's just say what it is. That doesn't mean it's always going to be that way, but that's the way it's been so far. He blew that game at the end, and then when the door was opened by the injury, by KD's injury, they fell apart. Maybe if they win that first game, they win the series. Maybe they're sitting here as champions today. So my point is this. My point is this. The window is still open. The question is, can your boy, can James Harden be clutch when the Rockets need? If he can, they can still win a championship.
Why can't you pick a side?
They won't. Period.
Stop putting this. Why can't you pick a side? Molly asked you a clear question. I don't know why you can't answer it.
I'm very clear. The window is open.
If this and if that, I want to know, what are they going to do? If this is, I don't want to hear
window
if,
is,
what are
the
they going
to
do?
The window is open. It's not an issue. If you want me to bet, I'm going to bet Harden, who hasn't come through under pressure, will continue not to come through under pressure. But I've watched sports
so the
for window long enough
then.
To know.
So you're agreeing with me the window closed
I've
then.
Watched sports for long enough to know that just when you think you've seen it all, just when you think you have someone figured out, they can surprise you. That's why we watch. So I'm not counting them out
Max,
forever, but the odds are against it.
Here's the bigger problem. When you have a front office, you have a coach, you have a player, guys that don't believe in each other, guys that are not thinking about today, they're thinking about tomorrow. You know what happens? Guys get selfish. You know what Dan Tony's going to coach for this year? He's going to coach for his next job. He's not coaching for this championship this year. James Harden's going to protect himself. Chris Paul's thinking about that bag, the longevity, okay? Guys like P.J. Tucker, I could have value in Philadelphia. I could have value with the Lakers. I could have value in Toronto. Guys are going to be looking to get out of there. You got to take care of yourself and your family once a team does not have the same hope or confidence
jokes aside,
in you.
Ryan,
and that's what's
gentlemen.
Happening.
Jokes aside, I think that there's a lot of wisdom there. I think that however many seconds you averaged the season, you picked some stuff up in those. Did they used to let you in the huddle? Because I want to introduce. But this is the only guy in the NBA has to be introduced some of his former teammates. But
the point is, the guy with two left feet.
Jokes aside, I think that there's wisdom there, that the odds are you're right, that will happen. But I will remind you that the Lakers don't have a team around AD and LeBron right now. Klay and KD are hurt. Kawhi has not yet signed
to the
Clippers.
Put a team around LeBron, that's the easy part.
Party is over. West is wide open. When we come back, Giannis takes home his first league MVP, but you're about to find out who the real MVP of last season is. Second Hour First Take coming up next. You can never go out. Never been to-